then Sunday it wasn't very nice, but I mean, I was a heated stall, so.
Gotcha.
But pretty much about for 10 minutes a day, I'd try to do a chair drill. We had a nice, like one of those chairs you take out to a tour event, the three folding thing. The way it popped up, like the handle came out a little bit, so it was something to stop my hip from sliding back.
Just something that provides some feedback.
Yeah.
Watch your web lesson at all?
Yeah, I watched it, I think just once. Maybe a few, like the one time that I watched the clips a few times.
All the things, like those three main things that we talked about, all those are really all aimed at trying to get that club to swing more on plane. And then we can work on your hands, but you really do lean the shaft nice coming down.
Yeah. Would it be better if I had on a darker shirt? As far
yes.
as...
Yeah. All right. I can switch with you if you want.
No, I got a black jacket. I'll put that on. Just looked at the video and saw that it's tough to kind of background it.
We'll look at your evaluation swing right now.
Okay.
And we'll look at it side to side with your before, just to kind of see what's different now than what it was the other day.
Okay.
You can see how quickly that club rotates to the inside
yeah.
for the forearm rotation. Forearm rotation in that direction. Rolls that club to the inside. Left arm, trailing arm a little bit more on top. Club face actually is toeing quite a bit, but it's matching up with your torso.
Okay.
Right? Roughly speaking, that's a pretty fair square face. Tons of shoulder tilt early, which I actually like that. And there we are at the top. A lot of shoulder tilt. What we're going to try and do, we're going to try and lower that right arm just a little bit. It's going to make it easier for you to drop that club back on plane. You're still steep. See how that wants to ride right down that lead forearm?
Yeah.
At this point, actually, probably one more frame forward. Somewhere between those two frames. You want that club right on that, along that left forearm.
Okay.
Or that shaft pretty close to parallel with the blue lines. But definitely better on the backswing, more vertical with the shaft. And as steep as you are on the right, you actually were a little steeper when you came in a couple weeks ago. Let's look from the front view. Get a little narrower maybe with your stance. It's about as wide as I want you with a six. You can get a little narrower with that.
Okay. I still kind of look like I'm leaning toward my front foot.
You are. You are.
Okay.
And that's already kind of pre-setting you to get steeper.
Yeah.
Right? A shallower swing, or one that can drop on plane into a shallower type of plane, is going to be one where you're kind of a little lower already with your trailing shoulder. I mean, you're right in the tour averages, but I want to get that kind of that right ear back behind that ball a little bit more.
Okay.
Or maybe even with the ball by just tilting to your left a little bit more with your torso.
Yeah.
But watch the difference here with your pivot. And that looks really solid against that. You're bracing really solidly against that left side. Your head works back maybe an inch or two, which is fine. For a guy as mobile and flexible as you, you don't need to move way off the ball in order to get the club on plane. So that little bit's just fine. There you go. A little bit of slide there. Okay. So what I want to do today, I want to work on two things.
I think one thing's going to be kind of easy. We're just going to kind of try to shorten your swing up.
Okay.
With your arms on the way back, which will try and eliminate a little bit of that lift. So for most of the time today, you're going to feel like you're just making maybe just a little bit more than a half swing.
Okay.
It will be more than half. It'll be probably more like 3/4, but it'll feel like it's about halfway back.
You want it like arm to go to parallel right
yeah.
here?
Not only parallel with the right arm, but I also want your right arm to feel like it's working deeper behind you.
Okay.
Yeah. It'll also help you keep the shaft more vertical. If your hands work deeper with the turn, it's easier to keep that shaft vertical. If your arms want to work out, typically you're
yeah.
going to want to roll that shaft flatter. You're already doing a better job of that, by the way, anyway, just from what we did a couple weeks ago. I want to do some stuff without a ball today to start with. Because you like to rotate too quickly from the top when you transition. And that's what gets your arms working out and that shaft working too vertical.
Okay.
So we're going to start to work on, from a less than full swing, about 3/4, left arm parallel, in your case right arm parallel to the ground. And then work on a transition where there's a lateral shift without any rotation first. Okay, so I'm gonna kind of help you through that. go up to the top and pause, or to about left arm, right arm parallel in your case. You know, do everything backwards. Relax this. This right shoulder down, and you're a little bit deeper here.
Okay. Okay.
Now, see how your hips are nice and turned, you're nice and solid against that left leg? Now, all you're going to do is you're going to have a little bit of a lateral shift this way without any rotation.
Okay.
And then you're going to let the hands come through. So there's going to be a little bit of a delay there where you're going to have a little bit of a shift, and I'll kind of mirror in front of you. Okay. Lateral shift. And you almost can let your, feel like you're almost letting your arms fall here. And then you can swing out to left field a little bit. So you get up here, and it's like you want to start to rotate already.
Uh-huh.
So we got to allow for a little bit of a lateral shift. Good. Go ahead and just shift that way. Good. Go that way. Good. Do that again. A little segmented right now, but okay. Bring that left foot a little narrower in towards your rig. There you go. Good.
Take a look at this, Craig. I want you to watch the orientation of your head to the ball. As soon as that head gets past that ball like that, you're in trouble.
Okay.
Okay.
What's that feel like when you're doing that?
What's it feel like? I mean, different. Definitely have to think about
we're
it.
We're going
to
make that more subtle because there's a lot of, you know, more lateral movement than we need, but we're just trying to get you used to moving that way.
Yeah, I mean, it's something I have to think about. Eventually, it'll get ingrained.
What percentage of effort do you feel you're using on those practice swings?
40.
Right. I want you to use 40 with the ball.
Alright. Have you got it down where you can put the ball on the tee with just the club?
Get your right foot in there.
Oh, no foot needed.
Well, I'm not as good as you, but yeah, sometimes you just do one of those deals.
That's no fun. It's too easy.
No. I don't have a steady hand. Is that better contact? Yeah, it felt a lot better. That was one of your best as far as the angle of the descent through the ball and all that stuff. You didn't hammer the ground real hard.
It was the best feeling contact of the day by far. If not, no question about it.
Go on. Lead arm parallel and nice and deep. You know what I mean by when I say deep? Deep is that dimension behind you, basically. So this would not be deep.
Yeah.
This would be deep.
Again, the shoulder turn?
It's from the shoulder turn, yeah.
Okay.
So right here, shift. 40%. There you go. Good too.
What'd you say?
That sounded pretty good too.
Yeah. Two in a row. If I get a third, it's going to start to be a streak, just like the Browns.
That is so much better. Yes. Good job there. Beautiful. And well, here's an interesting thing. Okay. That right arm parallel.
Yeah.
Look at how inside the ball you're pointing right there.
Yeah, before I was way on the outside.
So one of the most misunderstood concepts, you know, I have students come in and say, you know, my buddies tell me I'm way too flat.
Yeah.
Okay. And what you'll see is you'll see them taking the club outside, like their hands will work away from their body because they're not trying to take it inside. So at this point, their hands are like out here.
Yeah.
And you've rolled the shaft and it's like this.
Yeah. I mean, that's kind of how it was when I first came in.
Right. Obviously not to that extent, but but the way that you get the club more vertical is you get your hands actually working more in. Your hands in the grip are separate from the club head. Right?
Okay.
The angle of the shaft is a line between the grip and the head, right? So usually, the deeper your hands go, the easier it is to keep the club head you know, the other direction, and that's what's going to allow you to get the club more vertical. The more out you go, because you don't want to go flat, it just forces your forearms to roll more, and then the shaft falls back, and then you're flat. So it's almost counterintuitive to a lot of people to say, well, if I'm too flat, why would I feel like I go more in? That's what allows the club to get more vertical, though.
Yeah,
right. Most people's sensations of how long their swing is how much their arms travel relative to their torso, not how much their shoulders turn.
Yeah.
So you feel short, deep, but when you get deep, your shoulders return more, and then you're just not lifting.
Yeah.
And that's actually getting you in a much better position at the top.
So one of the things that you just didn't have a couple weeks ago was that stable trailing side.
So we were watching you the tiger.
Yep. And then you might have a little bit of a backing up of the hips now.
Okay.
Just a little bit. That's what I was talking about. There's some refinement there that we can get to. That's what I was talking about. But overall, you keep your head back.
You can see how your hips much more ahead. Your head. Torso has to move in this direction in order to get that club to shallow out. Okay, you're going to see that same motion with Tiger. Hips are forward. Head's back. That club's going to shallow out. Now if you look at where we started again, you're not going to have that same.
Half a head behind the ball.
I mean, it's a huge difference, right?
Yeah.
But it's a huge difference in the angle of your torso. Right? And just as big of a difference in the angle of the shafts coming down.
Better, but we're on our way. Cool. Keep rocking that.